How much do you know about Budgie or their bass player Burke Shelley? Let's find out today on Musician Series. Welcome to episode 3 of Musician Series. Before we get started, I do want to say, with the obvious rise in spiking with COVID-19, please be respectful and wear a mask. It's kind of unbelievable to go to any store right now that even states that we are requiring you to wear a mask, and people are still not doing it, even when they offer masks at the door. So again, just a friendly reminder to please at least wear a mask. So yeah, again, welcome to episode 3 of Musician Series. Last week I talked to local Michigan guitar player Nate Dill. The week before that I talked about one of my bass influences, Cliff Burton. This week I'll also be talking about another bass influence of mine, but getting in more depth to the one main band that he was in. That band is very unknown, but surprisingly a lot of people know who they are, and that band is Budgie. Budgie was a band that got started in 1967, and they're touted as being the cult unknown pioneers of heavy metal. Their first album was recorded the day of, in the same studio as, Black Sabbath's first album, and they never really got that popular. The people that are into Budgie believe this anyway, because of that fact that Black Sabbath recorded first. They were able to get their stuff into the States, and Budgie was not able to do that. What's interesting about Budgie is that there are multiple famous bands that have covered their music. Iron Maiden covering I Can't See My Feelings, Metallica covered Bread Fan, and I believe one other song. Nate, what was the other song on GarageBand? Or Garage Inc.? Crash Course and Brain Surgery. Yep. Crash Course and Brain Surgery was on Garage Inc. Megadeth covered one of their tunes. Even Iron Maiden covering I Can't See My Feelings, they didn't even know who Budgie was by name. They just put some band from Wales. And at the time, I'm assuming that's because they were doing a double bill when Iron Maiden was kind of still getting popular, and Budgie did a show with them, and then they ended up covering one of their songs. On a side note, that's actually kind of impressive, because, you know, you didn't have Ultimate Guitar, and you couldn't just go home and learn somebody else's songs, especially if it wasn't even a well-known band, which is the case in that situation. So they just heard the song once, and they were able to memorize that song enough to cover it on one of their albums, but they didn't even remember the band's name. That's interesting, whether it was a lie, which I doubt, or they really just forgot the band's name. Also, if it looks like I'm sweating my balls off, it's because I am. I have to turn the air conditioner off just so it doesn't go into the microphone. Anyway, yeah, Budgie was a band from the UK, Cardiff to be more specific. The band was started by Tony Bjork and Burke Shelley. Their first album came out a few years after they got started, and that album's called Squawk. Everything about this band is super not... It's really weird. Like, I think quirky is probably the best word to use. I just was trying to find a different word to use. Very bouncy, balloony, but still very heavy metal, especially for the time. Because even before they came out with their first album, they were still obviously recording, or not recording, but playing shows. And they were debuting this heavier sound, which at the time, just like with anything else that pioneered a different genre, that was way ahead of its time at that point, especially where they were. Budgie would go on to record multiple albums. There's stuff that goes all the way up into the 90s. The only static member to remain in that band would be its bass player and vocalist, Burke Shelley. Even more interesting, I saw an interview last year with Burke Shelley, how he is now. He looks like a skinnier version of Kratos of God of War, with a Gandalf beard thing going on, and he just looks kind of homeless, which is sort of sad in a way. There's all these weird, like, cell phony videos he's playing with just some rinky-dink local bar bands, and not that there's anything wrong with that, but there had to have been a weird fall from grace at some point, because even if they were not getting the attention that they deserved in the States, they were still very popular during their duration of their career. And that spans all the way from the late 60s up to, at least to note, the 2000s. Because you can still buy their albums today, and then they'll even have remastered versions on there of some of the songs they did in the 60s and 70s, and they did a different version in the 2000s. Way more heavy metal. Burke Shelley's voice now sounds like Dr. Roxo. But it's still kind of cool that they were still doing stuff. And, you know, at the peak of their career, people, like all these famous bands, were covering their songs. And it, even like with Iron Maiden, even though they weren't popular at the time of covering their song, if you look at Garage Inc. by Metallica, which has two Budgie songs on it, as we just talked about, Garage Inc. didn't come out till way, way later when Metallica was definitely already famous. I mean, you judge it off that Jason Newsted era, and they were definitely on top of the world at that point. So the fact that they covered their music and yet still... were people just not looking them up or something? The other thing is, too, is I was watching Lords of Dogtown with Maddie and Nate, and there's a Budgie song that's in that movie, and that was a pretty famous movie. The video game Brutal Legend has two of their songs in it, one of them obviously being Bread Fan. So it's kind of weird to see where these songs pop up, and yet they're still not as famous as I guess you would think. Like, oh, they have a song on a mainstream movie, and then they have a song in a video game, and... all these other bands are covering their music, but why does nobody know who they are? Pretty much, cheesily speaking, it's just because of that cult, you know, following. There's definitely that to them, and I don't mean like a Rush cult following, because everybody, you know, knows who Rush is, especially at this point, but like Budgie has like a full underground following. Of course, when they were first at the peak of their career, they had, you know, they were on their third album, and they were, if you go on YouTube, you can find them on TV shows over in the UK. The Midnight Special was one of them. Pretty much every single gig you saw from that era, they were just packing these huge venues. And when you look at their videos that were more recent, it literally looks like they took 15 steps backwards, and local... it just looks like some small bar punk gig where there's maybe 20 people there for this band. And in this case, since Burke Shelley's the only static member of Budgie in that band, they're mostly only coming to see this dude that was at one point looked like he could have been on top of the world. And I'm trying to hold it as much as I can. I'm basically just flip-flopping between points because I'm trying to not go ahead and talk about Burke Shelley, but I think I'm just going to go ahead and do that anyway. Burke Shelley was another one of my bass influences right after Cliff. I mean, it was in that order. For a while, you know, I wanted to play bass with my fingers because that's cooler, ride the strap really low, and pretty much do anything I could to emulate Cliff Burton. How I found out about Budgie was actually from Dave Mustaine's biography book. He had mentioned them a couple times as influences under, you know, Diamond Head was another band influence, you know, Tigers of Pantang, all that weird, you know, early new wave of British heavy metal stuff. And I was with my friend Clayton at the time, who had gotten me into Metallica and showed me the Cliff Burton video in the first place. And we immediately just had to take to YouTube and try to find him. And the first thing that came up was the Bread Fan music video. For me, being a bass player, that was almost just as cool as seeing the Cliff Burton video, but it was in a different way because Burke Shelley didn't do anything like super shreddy. But the way that he was playing bass, or at least tonally, the way he was playing bass was, okay, now I have to start playing bass with a pick. I thought that was the secret or something. He was playing on what I believe is a 1965 and or 67 P bass, and he pretty much used that throughout his whole career, but I guess we'll get into that. What was that? Did you fart? Are you serious?
I was like half awake.
Are you so you were sleeping and then you farted?
Yes.
And then it woke you up?
Yes.
You know that's going on this, right?
No, please, no. Please.
Dude, I hope the microphone caught that.
Please do not put it in the video.
Holy sh.
Oops.
Where the Oops. F was I? Burke Shelley used a P bass through his whole career. And at the time, obviously, I didn't know what P basses were. This is still my first year of getting into music. But I just wanted that type of bass sound that he used. He was using power chords on bass, which was already cool. The fact that he was using a pick, which, again, I was really embarrassed to even try to attempt using a pick just because everyone tells you not to if you're a bass player. But if you go and you check, like, pretty much any of that early Budgie stuff, he has his amp like hot, running really hot. Like all of his highs have got to be blasted. All of his mids, obviously really blasted. And the crazy thing is he didn't really have any low in his bass. And being that it's a P bass as well, and he definitely clearly jacked the tone knob all the way up too, on top of having highs and mids at full blast, it kind of had like a farty tone to it that was actually really cool. It's hard to imagine any of those early songs that were on Budgie's early records without that bubbly, bouncy bass tone. There was a lot to be influenced by, especially not only just in his tone, but the riffs that he was playing were really interesting. It just seemed like something that, you know, obviously the guitar player would probably do. And most of the time they did do a shitload of unison stuff between the guitar and bass playing the same thing. But then there was times where it would just go off on a tangent. Like it sounded like they really were just like, we're going to make a 2-minute song. Okay, this one is going to be 12 minutes. And it just has this weird jam in the middle. But then if you hear those songs live, they clearly have it down, like, locked in. Like, they actually did think about all these weird parts and mapped them out and then played them. It just felt like it was on the verge of loose, but somehow still precise. I don't know. It's kind of weird. Gutter sludgy is the word that, you know, I try to use, I guess, to describe Budgie. It's not for everyone, for sure, but I definitely, definitely recommend all of you check out any Budgie song, at least from, like, the 60s to 80s. There's Squawk, Never Turn Your Back on a Friend, Bandholder is another one, or you can just go straight to the Best of Budgie, which is also weird that they have the very Best of album, and they're still not that well known. If you notice the lighting change, I really needed to eat some food, so that took a little bit longer than it needed to. Just to try to wrap this up a little bit, if you haven't heard of Budgie, I do recommend you go on YouTube, Spotify, iTunes. They've got plenty of albums to look through, add it to your collection, or if you like it, obviously. But it's definitely worth a listen. It's definitely worth a listen. Burke Shelley is also the reason I actually wear these glasses. Little fun little fact. And he is one of the main reasons I play with a pick, if that interests anybody. Before I end this video, I do want to remind everybody, like, please be respectful and wear a mask. Tons of people are getting sick right now. It's definitely all the way down to young people. Kids are getting COVID. Just wear a mask. I don't think it's that tough. And before I end the video, I'm going to play a little piece of Budgie's Bread Fan. And don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, click the bell to be notified whenever a new video does come out. Next week, I'll be talking about a local artist, at least to my knowledge. Again, thank you for supporting what I do and listening to my music. Stay safe and support local. Thank you.